me Tamanna Rahman from class 9th. Going to say you something about direct and inverse proportion.
Shall I? The unit that I taught you a year before, maybe. Yes.
Basically, when you meet our topic, you will definitely ask me a question that what is this base? Here in today's world, when we are reading something, when we go to some point, it means that it is having a base. Without base, nothing is impossible here.
Nothing is possible.
Base is also important for direct and inverse proportion.
Good.
So, let us begin with this base, but you have to make sure that you are keeping an eye on all of my points, because this topic is somehow related to sinus as well. An Italian scientist whose name was Galileo Galilei. In his late years of his life, he was doing an experiment with the motion. When he did some wonderful discoveries, wonderful experiments, but the experiments he did, he wrote it in a treatise called as Dialogues Concerning Two New Sciences. That what he did in the experiment is he wrote all that experiment is in this treatise, which is called as Dialogues Concerning Two New Sciences. Basically, among his is that the distance covered by the consecutive equal time intervals by the balls rolling down the inclined plane is proportional to the successive odd positive integers.
Good.
Are you getting what I am trying to say? So this was the experiment what he wrote in this dialogue concerning two new sciences. Basically, you will tell me a question that what is the relation between this and the direct and inverse proportion. Here we go on our new point, that is, he also did the experiment in it, that is the uniformly accelerated motion. The discovery which I told you right now can be written in the form of d is equal to k times 2n minus 1. So why we are subtracting here the minus 1? Because I told you that that is proportional to the successive odd positive integer. If the number will be even, we will minus it and we will eventually get our even in the form of the odd.
Good.
It means that now there is a relation between the uniformly accelerated motion and the direct and the inverse proportion. He uses some mathematical model in this uniformly accelerated motion. Now here the question arises that what is the mathematical model? Mathematical model is an equation or a set of equations in which letters represent the real world quantities. Before I will make you understand that how this mathematical model is related to the direct and inverse proportion, let me give the example of the variable in algebraic expression. Basically, we say that variable, it is that quantity whose numerical value changes, whose value is not constant. In our day-to-day life, it is our hair growth, our height or our weight. But in mathematicals, we do not write our height, our weight or our hair growth there. What we write there, we write x, y, z in the form of the small letters we represent here, which is simply associated with the mathematical model. It means that when Galileo was doing an experiment with a uniformly accelerated motion, he didn't even try to write the distance in the form of the inclined planes in the form of any other thing. He wrote a mathematical model for this, which is also known as d is equal to k times 2 n minus 1. Basically, he did this mathematical model for his own sinus of dynamics, which is considered as to be his father, not the father of dynamics, the Galileo Galilei. But we use this mathematical model to study the variations. We use this mathematical, Galileo is his mathematical model for his sinus of dynamics, but we use this mathematical model for studying our variations, the variations are the direct and the inverse proportion. So here is the relation between the mathematical model and the direct and the inverse proportion.
Outstanding.
Here we go on our topic direct and inverse proportion. We can divide this topic into the direct proportion and inverse proportion. So basically, here what stands is here proportion. Proportion means that two quantities A divided by B and C divided by B are said to be in proportion if A divided by B is equal to C divided by B.
Very good.
So now here we go on our first topic, that's our direct proportion. Are you getting what I am trying to say? This first I showed you that what is the relation between this mathematical model and the direct and inverse proportion. Now we will go to our topic, that is the direct proportion. To make you better understand about the direct proportion, let us go to an example. Imagine that you are going to buy the candles for your party or decoration or anything else. When you go to the shop, if you will buy more candles, you have to pay more money, and if you will buy less candles, you have to pay less money. Here the number of candles we denote by X, and the number and our pay we denote as Y. For example, you have to buy 4 candles and you have to pay 10 rupees. Now you have to get 2 candles and you have to pay only 5 rupees for it. It means that if there is an increase in X, there is an increase in Y. And if there is a decrease in X, there is a decrease in Y. So which is related to our direct proportion, and mathematically we express it as two quantities X and Y are said to be in the direct proportion if there is an increase in X and increase in Y and decrease in X and decrease in Y. So here is our
big clap.
It means that, so now you will ask me a question, why is this only X and Y? I have already told you that mathematical model is just that of equations in which the letters represent the real world quantities. So these are our real world quantities, but we represent it in the form of the X and
Y.
So here we now go on our another topic, which is the inverse proportion. But some examples of the direct proportion are,
don't go for example, just go for inverse proportion.
So our inverse proportion is that our imagine that you are working in an industry. So you are the only one person in that industry, and you have to make 3 doors. You are the only one person in that industry, and you have to make 3 doors, but you are taking 4 days to complete the 3 doors. Now imagine there is a visit of the another person. So tell me, I will ask you a question. Will the said task take more time or less time if there will be the visit of the another person?
Yes.
Less time. Obviously it will take less time, because he will have a given doing some work. You will do some work and he will do some work, then you will finish the task in the less time. It means now here we go on this. You are the only one person. You have to make 3 doors. You are taking 4 days. Now there is a visit of the another person. Now you have to do the same work, that is 3 doors, but it takes now only 2 days. This is our X and this is our Y. Here, when there is a decrease in X, there is an increase in Y. When there is an increase in X, there is a decrease in Y. So these are said to be in the inverse proportion, and mathematically we represent it as two quantities A and B are said to be in the inverse proportion if there is an increase in X but decrease in Y, and decrease in X but increase in Y. So they are said to be in the inverse proportion. So, but now at last I have to tell you something, that is that Without them, what is the purpose of our studying the direct and inverse proportion? We have delivered here a lecture of 5 minutes, but what is its purpose? It has its purpose in the real world. It means that it makes us able us to understand that how quantities or how amount of quantities they are related to each other. Here, this is the example that how our candles and how the pay is related to each other. It means that it is useful in our day-to-day life. Here we go on the first, it is base, then what is direct and inverse proportion, and it is used in day-to-day life.
So outstanding, better.